I have decided to be educated. I have decided to be educated. I promise on my honor to be faithful and loyal to Ghana, my mother.
The development of any society, in any nation for that matter, hinges on quality education. Basic education, therefore, is a must for all children if this declaration should come to pass. The United Nations Sustainable Development Goal 4 urges all nations to ensure inclusive and equitable quality education and promote lifelong learning opportunities for all. In this direction, no child must be denied education based on culture, religion, ethnicity, or especially based on gender, physical or psychological deformity, among many other disabilities. It is for this reason that Voluntary Service Overseas, an international charity, in partnership with some active local non-governmental organizations, initiated a project called Tackling Education Needs Inclusively, TENI, in northern part of Ghana, the most poverty-endemic area of the country, where educating vulnerable and excluded children, most of whom girls and children with disabilities, is largely a mirage.
The TENI project has been running for almost 8 years now. It actually started in March 2009, and the first phase ended as at early 2014.
Phase 1 of TENI saw great successes and therefore the need for a second phase, which VSO and its partners implemented to ensure inclusive quality education for all children in their catchment area. Once again, the successes chalked up in this second phase of the TENI project is immeasurable.
The first phase of the project, we reached out to almost about 35,000 plus children. A significant number of them were girls. So this current phase, we are targeting 14,938 across all the districts.
Yes, Rita.
Abstinence is the total staying away from sex until marriage.
An important medium that has contributed immensely to the successes attained under the project is girls' clubs in the various beneficiary schools. Through the clubs, girls are now able to actively engage in taking initiatives, planning for themselves, and making their own choices.
We have learned a lot from this club, especially me, when I was feeling shy. By this time, I can even stand in front of, even if the president comes here and asks me a question, I can even stand and be bold to answer the question.
We had early marriages, teenage pregnancies, elopement. They were all issues in the district. But the inception of TENI has really kept those situations. Previously, we used to record a higher rate of pregnancies even at our BCE. Last year, when they were writing the BCE, I think it had gone very low. A village where TENI is operating, Gwabulga, was led in the 2015 BCE in teenage pregnancy. And it will surprise you to know that 2016, there was not a single girl who got pregnant during the BCE exams time.
Formerly, elopement cases, dropout rate, and even pregnancy cases were so rampant in Jinapa district. And the intervention of TENI, I think, have helped reduce these issues. For instance, in 2013-14, the pregnancy case was alarming in Jinapa district. About 218 girls were pregnant, and because of TENI intervention, the number have decreased in 2016 up to date. Only one case was recorded.
On the demand side, capacities of the District Education Oversight Committee, school management committees, and parent-teacher associations have been built, thus empowering them to be more responsible and lead in demanding quality teaching and learning of their wards, especially girls and children with disabilities.
7 plus 4.
Children with special needs who are less visible in the classroom and boys who are marginalized and at risk of dropping out of school are also beneficiaries of the project. The TENI project may have come to an end, but the beneficiaries are well equipped and ready to continue where VSO and its partners left off. Communities are much enlightened about inclusive quality education. Vulnerable girls and children with disabilities are now able to attend school, hoping for a brighter future where their potential will be fully realized.
I've gotten material support from the club, which are books and some uniform. Last year, I was able to get a uniform to wear and some books. Madam has also taught me of how to use the sanitary pad when I get my first menses. And I, for instance, have not gotten. But since I'm able to get the information about it, I'll be able to know what to do if I get it.
I have decided to be educated. I have decided.